week, you judge, and I'm Lisa Boothe in for Laura Ingraham tonight, and this is a special Thanksgiving Eve edition of the Ingraham Angle. Coming up, politics isn't taking a break for the holiday. Republicans going after the Clinton Foundation before they lose control of the House. And U.S. troops are spending Thanksgiving protecting our border from reports of a human stampede by caravan migrants. The dangerous details coming up. And shocking new videos reveal what college students really think about Thanksgiving. Spoiler alert, they say it's racist. Plus, Raymond Arroyo and Laura break down Thanksgiving do's and don'ts. They also talk to a real live turkey expert. But first, a subcommittee chairman of the powerful House Oversight Committee hinting to Fox News tonight that there may be new evidence that the Clinton Foundation is involved in illegal activity. Congressman Mark Meadows said in a December 5th hearing on the Hill to see where the Justice Department stands and the Clinton Foundation in pay-to-play allegations. And says there may be some whistleblowers willing to testify as well. Fox Chief Intelligence Reporter Catherine Herridge is here, and she's got the story.
Lisa, tonight House Republicans are trying to finish off some of their investigative work before they lose control of House committees, including the Clintons and their controversial charity.
Why don't you give back the money? I think it would be a great gesture.
On the campaign trail, candidate Trump had harsh words for the Clinton Foundation.
It's a criminal enterprise. Saudi Arabia giving $25 million, Qatar, all of these countries.
Writing to Congress last spring, then Attorney General Jeff Sessions tapped a Utah federal prosecutor, John Huber, to probe the foundation which took tens of millions of dollars from foreign interests while Clinton was Secretary of State under President Obama. While the foundation set up by Clinton and her husband has consistently denied wrongdoing, House Republicans are now calling for Huber to testify about his findings. In a phone interview, Congressman Mark Meadows said the hearing will be public.
On December 5th, the Subcommittee on Government Operations will be holding a hearing where we'll request Mr. Huber or his designee to come in and testify, along with potentially a couple of whistleblowers based on previous conversations with the Department of Justice weeks ago. They had indicated that Mr. Huber was making good progress.
Meadows, chairman of the Freedom Caucus, said congressional investigators also have new records about the foundation's work.
There's at least a question of impropriety as it relates to the Clinton Foundation, whether it's quid pro quo, whether it's improper use of charitable giving.
Along with the foundation, Huber is investigating allegations of surveillance warrant abuses targeting Trump campaign aide Carter Page. The Justice Department Inspector General is also investigating alleged surveillance abuses, as well as media leaks by the DOJ and FBI to include former FBI Director James Comey and his memos about his meetings with the president. Fox News reached out to the U.S. Attorney's Office in Utah, the Clinton Foundation, but there was no immediate response. With less than 6 weeks before the Democrats take over the House, the Huber testimony may be the last chance for Republicans to get foundation evidence into the congressional record. Lisa?
Thank you, Catherine. And joining me now is Corey Lewandowski, Trump's 2016 campaign manager and co-author of the new book, Trump's Enemies, out next Tuesday. And Antoine